Let us now do a demo on momentum conservation. So what you see here is called a Newton's cradle. It's got multiple pendulums, multiple bobs attached to strings suspended like this. And let us see how momentum conservation applies to this problem. So initially, I pull this bob away. So when I pull it away, I raise its height. So I give it some gravitational potential energy. When I release it, that potential energy will be converted to kinetic energy. That means the bob will start to have some velocity, some speed. And so let me release this. And the masses of the bobs are approximately similar. So at the instant of the collision, this bob is traveling to the left with some velocity. And you can see that velocity is being transferred across. And then at the end, this bob is traveling in the same direction with almost similar velocity. Let's try this again. And then when this bob is coming in with the opposite velocity, the momentum is getting transferred across each of these bobs and ultimately to the end. And this bob is also traveling at the same velocity. Now let me do a slightly different case. I pull both of these bob away from each other. And that means their velocities will be opposite initially. So the total momentum in the system is the sum of the individual momentums. All of those will be zero. The total momentum will be zero. And let's see what happens. And you can see that right after the collision, the bobs are also moving in the opposite direction. So their velocities have opposite signs. So again, the total momentum is zero. So momentum is conserved. Now it is important to note when we can apply the principle of momentum conservation and when we cannot. So during the collisions, we are analyzing the problem with the conservation principle of momentum. But when I am raising the bob to a height, I cannot apply the principle of momentum conservation. And why is that? Because if you remember from your lecture, we can apply the principle of momentum conservation only when there is no net force acting on the system. Now, when I have pulled it like this, the gravitational force that is acting vertically downward is no longer balanced by the tension in the string. So when it was here, it was balanced. Tension was pointing up and the gravitational force was pointing down. But now it is no longer pointing down. There is a component of the tension acting in this direction. So then we cannot actually apply the momentum conservation principle here. But during the collision, again, the forces are balanced, the vertical tension force and the gravitational force. There is no net force. And then we can apply the principle of momentum conservation. So you can do fun things with that and analyze this problem with momentum conservation. Let me pull two bobs away now and release them. That's a very interesting case. So you see two of these bobs are moving together. And you can keep going like this. So let me try to see what happens if I pull four bobs and release. Four of these masses move together. And you can still see that momentum is conserved. Not sure if this will work, but just for fun, let me try five bobs. And now you can see the middle bob is actually moving. In one instance, it's moving with the right masses, and in the other instance, with the left set of masses. So you can play with this, do fun things, and analyze the problems with principle of momentum conservation.